family. So I swear, ever since Sean and I went to Prague and Serbia and Istanbul for our vacation, I'm looking for holes to crawl into, ledges to jump up off of, in order to find some cool places to shoot some video. So this video is about free software. I want to give you some free stuff that costs me nothing and will cost you nothing so you can run your Airbnb business. So we are not talking about products like Beyond Pricing. We're not talking about Guesty. We're not talking about Wheelhouse, all the stuff that you think you need to run an Airbnb business. Here's some cool stuff that you didn't know you needed. So this comes from some subscribers that have presented to me some problems, and through their logic, I realized you guys need some resources. So a guest, hold on for the wind. Let this wind come. Score. I like it full suit. I could use the air conditioning. Haven't got all day, Mother Nature. Thank you. We're gonna do this through the wind anyway because we can. Let me fix my tie. Okay, so the first one comes from a subscriber who had a situation where he's worried that he's gonna get in trouble. He let one of his friends stay where they booked, and I think he probably gave them like money back, and they stayed and left a review for them, you know, as friends. And he's worried he's gonna get in trouble because somebody called him out on it. But his point for doing this was not only did he want the review, but he wanted his friends to answer a questionnaire, like a survey, because his property was new. And I'm like, ah. So first off, you didn't have to give somebody a free stay. You could have got somebody to stay for cheap, but here's a free resource if you want to do surveys and you want them to look good, and that's why you didn't want a stranger doing them. So this is typeform.com. This is something that I used for years before I learned like the nuances of it and how to write it myself, and so I do some basic typeform stuff. But essentially what it is a survey or questionnaire website where you create just like a list of questions and they answer, and it's really smooth and beautiful, and it's just a great way to ask people questions and get the data. And there's an admin panel, you can get all the data and it can break it down. If they do multiple choice, it'll give you percentages of who answered A and B. It's way cool. So it's free. There's a like paid version of it that allows you to do some really fun things with it, like really specific features, but you don't really need those if you're just doing it to have people answer like a small survey. Right, so you can use surveys at the very beginning of running an Airbnb property to find out if there's anything you're missing. You can do it as an ongoing thing to check up on your cleaners. You know, continue to inspect what you expect. And the best way is to ask your customers if you're doing a bad job. So, number two, and no, I'm not gonna tell you about Google Calendars because we've already talked about Google Calendars. It is the most awesome free software ever. If you don't know why, watch the other videos, right? Okay, so, number two is another freemium. It's called WeWork. WeWork is like a scheduling software, human resources kind of thing. You can create a schedule for your cleaners, for example. So you say, hey, Johnny's gonna work these hours at this location. Now, the free version isn't quite what I wanna talk to you about. There's a paid version that lets you do clocking in and clocking out based on GPS location. So the thing is, when you hire cleaners, right, you're gonna pay them by the hour, which is lowering your cleaning cost because otherwise you'd be paying somebody else a lot more by the hour. Problem is time theft when you have your own employees. So if you're paying somebody $12 to $15 an hour, you wanna know that they're there working where they said they were going to be. So here's how we do this. WeWork, you pay for the slightly more expensive version, you put your cleaners into the system, they download an app on their phone, and you set your homes as GPS locations. And if they wanna clock in, they have to be at a home to clock in. They can't clock in from their house, preventing time theft. So I used to use this program too with my sales teams. I wrote a very basic version of this because it is kind of complex. So you could write your own version of this if you wanted to. And if you want to, message me, comments, right? Okay, last one isn't necessarily free, but it is free. So this one's called Upwork. So Upwork is a site where you can find people to outsource stuff to. One of my favorite subscribers, we talk all the time, she's always active, thank you by the way and hi, she told me that she's too busy to expand her Airbnb business because of everything else she has going on. I asked her if she thinks she's relying on herself too much, and she said, well, it's kind of hard to outsource because it's expensive. The only thing I can really see outsourcing would be like my IT stuff, that like WordPress related stuff. And I'm like, have you heard of WeWork? So WeWork, you can find people to do programming, IT, phone support, virtual assistant, telemarketing, like just any real position that somebody can do through their phone or their laptop, and they can screen share to prove to you that they're working. You can find those employees or contractors on wework.com. And because they're all from different countries, you can find people super cheap. Sean Ray, my traveling buddy, he's found people to do stuff for like a buck an hour American, because they're from some island that $1 is good. So these softwares are absolutely awesome. The free versions, the paid versions, have fun with them. And of course, one day I'll do like a Wheelhouse or a Beyond Pricing review. But right now we still manage our stuff manually and we're doing great. So if you have any questions about automating software, how I decided to shoot here of all places, leave it in the comments. Thank you for watching Airbnb Automated, and I will see you on the other side.